Husband is dead.
Kirstie Alley's having a bad day. Sibling rivalry, Sunday at 10 on 4.
Afore it were light, I'd hear our dad getting up to get oven going. He were a right good baker, were our dad, and right proud of his ovies. I liked it hot from the oven, and when smell crept upstairs, I knew it were ready, and time I were up. It were better than any alarm clock.
Ovis is still baked fresh every day. It's as good today as it's always been.
From Gino Ginelli, Toffee Fuji. Vanilla and toffee icy cream with a toffee saucy swirls and Fuji beads. Gino Ginelli, the ice of passion.
And I'm feeling good. Fishing the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
Everyone's a fruit and nut case.
Lump and fruity.
Boy, what a cutie.
Funky, chunky almonds.
They're the secret of my beauty. Ah! Everyone's a fruit and nut case. Maybe it's a tasty Cadbury's chocolate. Give it an ovation. What a combination. Cadbury's fruit and nut.
Better way to find the ultimate refreshment? 7-Up. Extreme refreshment.
The boffins at Harpic have designed a toilet freshener with odor neutralizers that help novel myths. Harpic with odor neutralizers.
What's funny about childbirth?
Between two teams to see who can give birth first before our consultant decides to do a cesarean!
Pulling teeth is no laughing matter.
I've never had any trouble with my teeth. Well, I had them all out when I was 20.
And doctors are certainly no joke.
To a man, we say, what's the problem? To a woman, what seems to be the problem?
Imelda Staunton presents It's a Girl, tomorrow at 10 on Channel 4.
More Gaelic charm from Antoine and Jean-Paul as they serve up another helping of Eurotrash in 35 minutes. Before that, Jo Brand is here for the last in her present series. If I'd known, I'd have baked a cake.
Cream 6 ounces of butter and caster sugar. Then break 3 eggs and fold them into the mixture. Add 6 ounces of flour, spoon into cake tins and cook at gas mark 5. After 25 minutes, remove from the oven and leave to cool for, well, says half an hour, but sod that. Pour on 3 glasses of brandy and add some cream. Add some more cream. Add some more cream. Serve with custard, ice cream and no friends. And garnish with bars of chocolate and a large pork pie.
Hello and welcome to tonight's show. Now, a lot of people criticise supermodels, don't they? And I think it's very unfair, actually. I do, because they can't answer back, can they? Too bloody stupid to understand the question. And I actually, I never saw myself following that route, you know. I never wanted to have a career as a supermodel, because imagine that, like, earning millions, and you can't go down the caff and celebrate with a Black Forest ghetto, can you? Just totally unfair. And I never really understood the difference between a model and a supermodel, you know. And the only way I can think of comparing it is, like, with Tampax and Super Tampax. Because, put them, you know, compare the two of them, and basically, Tampax, Super Tampax, model, supermodel, you know, the super variety is a bit more expensive and a lot thicker, really. You know. Barbie is 35 years old, apparently, this year. Doesn't look it, does she? Plastic surgery, no doubt. And the thing about Barbie is people say her proportions are very odd, you know, like really long legs. And I reckon that if you scale Barbie up to sort of normal size and turned her into a real woman, that I'd punch her in the bloody gob. Shape is an odd sort of thing. Apparently Steve Davis said recently that women shouldn't play snooker because they're the wrong shape. Well, I'm exactly the same shape as Bill Werbenick, and he sings so much. But sport is weird, I think, because there's a lot of worry, particularly with boxing at the moment, that it causes an awful lot of long-term damage, you know. And Henry Cooper's commented on it recently. He's actually said boxing is a man's sport and it doesn't cause brain damage. And boxing is a man's sport and it doesn't cause brain damage. So thank you for that, Henry. But the one thing about medicine in sport, it is actually getting a lot more sophisticated, because I don't know if you know this, but recently six scientists actually crossed a monkey with a pig, and they produced a creature that can actually peel a banana with its trotters. Apparently Lazio have expressed an interest. Now, I think I'm going to go for a little walk down here and threaten someone. Now, you see, tabloids are strange as well. I actually think The Sport is the best name that you could think of for a tabloid, isn't it? Especially if you consider masturbating a sport. And rugby's a sport, and that's played by a load of wankers, so fits in pretty well, doesn't it, really?
And we'll be cruising at an altitude of 30,000 feet. Now our lovely hostesses will demonstrate the safety procedure and welcome you on board this flight.
Good morning and welcome to Slapper Atlantic Dotter. Right, let's get the safety routine over with. There are two exits at the front.
There are.
And one at the back.
That one's yours.
A line of lights will guide you to the exit, and a line of urine will guide you to the bogs.
The oxygen masks are located here and will dangle in front of your heads in case of an emergency, much like most of you sad middle-aged businessmen after 8 G&Ts, eh? Remind you of anything?
Now, I know that you overgrown office boys think that the airline is the last bastion of machismo, what with words like cockpit, joystick, and forward thrust. But just let me tell you that on this flight, the undercarriage won't be dropping, the flaps will be staying closed, and we won't be going down.
Time for complimentary drinks. Oh, six empty seats over there. Shame to waste.
Now, I do hope that you enjoyed the complimentary drinks we served you earlier on. Just let me point out that I did put some extra strength bromide in them so that when we arrive at our destination, no popping off to the red light district, perhaps have to go to the hotel and write a letter to your wives, bash the bishop, possibly.
Now, sit back, relax, and enjoy your in-flight entertainment, which is, in fact, a home movie, and me, Brandy, and the waiters having one hell of a time in Tenerife. Mind you what you're missing, losers. Bon voyage.
Cheers.
Hello, I'm your new neighbour. Oh. I appear to have run out of coffee. You don't have any, do you?
Yum. No, I don't drink coffee. What
tea do?
Fine.
It appears to be a bit moist. Think of me when you're plunging it in. Anywhere.
You should have brought the bloody dog down with you.
Hang on, I think that's him over there. Quick! Oh, God, we'll never catch him now.
Gav?
What?
Pony!
You can't get on that.
Why not?
I'll have the RSPCA on you.
Quick, Jane, you go on ahead. I'll meet you at the pier, okay? And as for you, you're going down. Boy, come back here, sugar.
One fat lady.
Watch it, Sammy.
No.
Look, Jane, I want a leg waxer.
A nice one. I'm not signing the dog yet.
Come on, I've got an idea. I want to arrange a stakeout.
Right. Love. I think we're going round in circles.
Oi, these are for kids only.
Please.
No sign of Taggart, boss.
Oh, can we, boss? Just one go on the dodgems.
Right, just one. Keep them peeled, son.
Oh, boss, I love the dodgems.
Watch it or I'll have you up on a charge.
Eating all that candy floss. Pig!
He's not a copper. That's my Dave. Oi, Dave, what the hell are you doing here?
Love, I've been looking for you everywhere. Kids are driving me mad. No clean pants for a week.
No clean pants for a week? Let's just go and have a cuppa, Dave.
Oh, you've got to leave the full sweetheart. I can't cope without you.
She's a good copper, though.
A damn good copper, Dave.
Bugger that. I haven't had hot dinner in 7 years.
Let's just go home and talk about this. One last burn up, then, Jane. Coming?
Yeah, why not? Old time's sake. Yeah, Dave.
Where are those fruit gums, then, Jane?
I'll find them, Gov.
Oh, I know where they are. Anything to eat? Oh, no, it's not my fault. I couldn't see where I was going. Taggart ate me bloody contact lenses. Come on, you. Let's get back to that B&B, you Wars. Know. I think the water must have washed through your underpants by now, mate. Taggart. A lot of women moan about periods. I don't, because I think they're brilliant, actually. Especially if you know someone who lives next door who you can't stand, who's got a white sofa. periods is lots of people are very embarrassed about them, aren't they? And they don't like to actually use the word. Period. So what they do is they use a selection of very strange little euphemisms so they don't have to say, I've got my period. And among my favourites are, I've got the painters and decorators in. Arsenal are playing at home. I have to say, actually, my own particular favourite is, there's a vast amount of blood squirting out of my gusset. Oh,
Oh, hello. Can I have my tea bag back, please?
I'm afraid it's gone a little limp.
Don't worry, I'm sure I can squeeze an extra half a cup.
Oh! I thought you were coming round to empty my pot.
I was. Seems like you've been getting your little perforation somewhere else. No, I'm moving out. You can leave that for the next tenant.
More women moving in?
No, some chimps. I'll make a nice cup of tea. Coogan's shifter!
Discover freedom with new Tampax Compact. It's more discreet, and with its new compact applicator and rounded tip, it's much easier to use. Tampax Freedom. Why compromise?
Cupronor High Performance Wood Stain lasts for 4 whole years.
It's all worked out beautifully.
Ryvita, high in fiber, and only 25 calories per slice. So get into Ryvita and zip into shape.
Blasé.
Passé.
Okay.
Cliché. Obvious.
Tedious.
Frivolous.
What a wuss. Speechless.
Pepsi Max. Maximum cola taste and no sugar.
Obsessed.
Possessed.
Impressed.
No contest.
Live life to the max.
Want to get into movies?
Yes! Yes!
And a yes, and a yes.
Are you between 16 and 20?
Oh, yay!
Would you like 5 2-pound Cinemar vouchers?
Gee, let me think.
Yes.
Open a TSB interest check account and near yours. What do you say?
Yes! Yes! Yes!
TSB, we want you to say.
Yes, that's correct.
Hello, Sky. Hello, Gabs. Hello, Sheep. Isn't it a beautiful day?
Hello, Mr. Frog. I bet that if I were to give you a kiss, you'd turn into a handsome sheep shearer.
Oh, yeah!
Castle Mine is made with golden clusters.
You haven't got a sister, have you?
The experienced hoppers wouldn't give a Castle Mine 4X for any other lager.
On New Year's Eve 1879, Lord Fairfield Buxton attempted to spend a night alone in the fabled Valley of the Kings. By midnight, he had fled in abject terror, yet could never speak of what he had experienced. Why? In London, in 1989, housewife Janet X and her mother found themselves visited by alien beings who abducted them, analysed them with unearthly technology, and only returned them to normality the next day. Why? These and other astonishing phenomena can only be explained in one way. They must have been pissed. They must have been pissed by Barshall Bavendish, Week by week, you can build up this pointless library of magazines about absolute cobblers. Buy issue one, and you'll find out why 80 million readers have been reading Barshall Bavendish titles for over 20 years. They must have been well pissed.
Thus, historical necessity foresees the victory of the working classes, the triumph of social justice, and the end of slavery. Can you heat this up for me, Ducks? It's gone a bit cold.
Oh, I've had enough of this, you dozy layabout.
There's a problem, my cock sparrow?
Oh, just a few. I mean, we've had the bailiffs round, the roof's leaking, and that's the last sausage in the house. When are you going to get a proper job?
A proper job? I am Karl Marx's lover. People come from all over Europe to hear me speak at the Clerkenwell Working Men's Club.
Yeah, to hear you say one more for the road, Daisy. What do you know about the working classes anyway?
I have studied them, dollface. I have seen the humiliating rags they are forced to wear in the coal pits of Stepney.
All very well having a theory on the accumulation of capital in the industrialized world, but when are you going to come up with a theory that gets your white shirts clean? And I mean close-up clean.
Are you unhappy with the division of labour in our marriage, my trouble and strife?
You, Carl, are a poxy chauvinist. I mean, you won't even let us women in down the labour club.
Now, that is because the female comrades have their own organisation, subcommittee and distinct party sections. And on top of that, you're always spilling your baby sham on the pool table, innit?
This book you're writing.
Oh, my masterwork, yeah.
Das Kapital.
Yes.
I mean, let's face it, no one in history is ever going to read it. It's 85 volumes. Look at this, for example. Chapter 154, The Communist Ideal. Last night I heard my mama singing a song.
Oh, be a chubby, chubby, cheap, cheap.
I looked up this morning and my mama was gone.
Be a chirpy, chirpy, cheep, cheep, chirpy, chirpy, cheep, cheep, cheep.
Is that a drivel? What about this? Modern warfare in contemporary society. The man at the back said everyone attacked. And it turned into a ballroom blitz.
Ballroom blitz.
Why can't you just condense it all down, the communist ideal, into one sentence like, I love you, love me, love.
But isn't that part of Buddhist philosophy?
No, it's from a young man called Gary Glitter. He's only just started, but I've got the feeling he's going to be around for some time.
Now then, the redistribution of wealth. I condemn all unearned money.
Oh, do you?
I condemn all capitalist gambling.
Better not show you this, then.
At last, the end of the age of money is at hand.
Oh, dear, better go on my own, then, and redistribute a bit of wealth down the shops. Your gym palace can cash a million. See you in Utopia, you loser.
What news do you bring?
I bring news of a great miracle.
What sort of miracle is it you have seen?
It is the Son of God. He did speak to the people, and he did anoint them with his words, and he did turn to them, and lo, he did feed 5,000 with 5 loaves and 2 fishes.
He fed 5,000 people with 5 loaves and 2 fishes?
Yes.
Well, each? 5 loaves and 2 fishes each?
No, no, no. Between them all.
What, as a starter?
What?
Yeah, you know, like a finger buffet, a little snack before the proper meal.
No, no, this was the meal. Surely it is a miracle.
And what about pudding?
What?
What, didn't they have any pudding?
No, they did not have any pudding.
So they had no starter. No pudding, 5 loaves and 2 fishes between the lot of them.
Yes!
It is surely a miracle.
Yeah, a miracle. They didn't string him up.
It was a sign.
Yeah, a sign that you shouldn't go round to his place for dinner.
Heretic woman.
Oh, suit yourself. All I can see is he should get someone else in to do the catering.
Forgive her, Lord, for she knows not what she is saying.
Are there any exciting leftovers? A lot of people worry these days about the increase in vigilantism, and I don't, because I think it's a great idea. I think it's great. And, you know, there are, like, sort of slightly fascistic neighbourhood watch schemes operating, or in sort of posh areas, neighbourhood SWAT, I think they're good. But round where I live, we have our own little scheme, and it's called Neighbours Watch, and, if you miss neighbours, someone comes and tells you whether bouncers had a shag or not. So it's very handy. And graffiti these days isn't what it used to be, is it? I used to like old graffiti. I mean, it was never spelt right, and it was always sort of wrong in sentiment. I'll give you an example, actually. After all the Bobby Sands thing in the 80s when he went on hunger strike, I actually read a bit of graffiti on a toilet wall that said, "Billy Sands, we will never forget you." The women in the audience agree with me, but with the increase in crime, you know, it's getting harder for women to go out on their own at night, and we're all absolutely terrified about these psychos wandering around the streets that should be locked up. Now, some people call them the mentally ill. I don't. I call them blokes. Waves of hate coming from the men. Not going to get off with anyone tonight. Oh, good, because I'm a bit sweaty. So that's all right. And I don't know, actually, if the other women in the audience feel this, that the papers, like, really wind you up, you know, with these horrible, grisly headlines. And with me, like, every time I walk past a billboard, if it says something like, sort of, rapist escapes from Rampton, I know that that man has got my address and he is on his way to my flat as we speak. Because the old imagination goes mad, doesn't it? You get in, you look under the bed, you look in the wardrobe, and then you convince yourself that he's got under a cup on the draining board. I don't know how you do it, but you do convince yourself. But very good excuse for not doing the wiping up, I've found, if you've got a strict mum. And the thing about burglaries is a lot of people sort of say, oh, you know, if you have your house burgled, you feel really dirty as though they've gone through all your things. No, you just feel bloody pissed off they've nicked your video. And a lot of burglars make a terrible mess, don't they? They turn everything out. And last time I was burgled, they just turned out all my cupboards. But I was quite pleased because I found an after eight I'd been looking for ages. And, I have to say, like, I don't know whether the courts help women or not, really. I'm not sure that they do. I mean, a mate of mine was in court recently. Her flat had been burgled. She had to go and give evidence. And the judge said that it was her fault because she was wearing a sexy nightie. He did. And so she got done for contributory negligee. Oh, what a great joke to finish on. Thank you very much. Good night. And as we move into our penultimate round, we see the scores. The Chumleys on 780, the Chumleys from Cheltenham there, and the Gibsons from Grimthorpe on nothing. Okay, right, that's enough of that. Now, normally we would have a round at this point known as Name That Classical Symphony. But this week, bit of a change, I've decided to introduce a new round known as Fight You Toffee-Nosed Tossers. All you have to do is punch the lights out of each other, and the one that causes the most damage wins. So if young Master Gibson would like to line up against the elderly Mr. Chumley.
It's only a game, isn't it?
And the Gibson's coming into their own, I feel.
Well, I'm calling Can I just say I thoroughly enjoyed the TV series. It was a real pleasure. It's great to see young performers like yourself getting an airing on TV these days.
Who the hell are you?
Steve Coogan. I do comic characters, Paul Carf, Alan Partridge. Quite good reviews, I think.
Oh, piss off.
Entertainment? Then we'll give you entertainment. You want the biggest, the brightest, and the best? You want to be shocked, stunned, and humored? You want to experience something your ears won't believe, your eyes won't understand, and your senses just won't want to deal with? You want to be made to suffer a severe side-splitting pain through excess laughter? Then you want to stay home, switch on, and tune into the return of Viva Cabaret! Next Friday at 10:30 on 4.
In 1951, a policeman was murdered. One boy fired the gun, but another was hung.
Blame Abby!
The film that chronicles the tragic story of Derek Bentley. Tuesday at 10 on 4.
Everyone's favourite Spanish director, Pedro Almodovar, previews his new film in Eurotrash after the break.
Discover freedom with new Tampax Compact. It's more discreet, and with its new compact applicator and rounded tip, it's much easier to use. Tampax freedom. Why compromise?
As the name implies, Cuprinol Quick Dry Wood Stain dries in just 1 hour. It lasts years.
I want to order something to go.
Tell them it's for Harry Klugman the Ninth.
Did you hear that?
It's Harry Klugman the Ninth.
The Harry Klugman.
He wants the best bagel chips in New York.
I want the pastrami ones.
Did you hear that?
This looks like a job for now.
Is it a bird?
No, it's a plane.
No, it's a fat chef.
Can you tell me the way to Medemsley Road?
Pay attention, Phileas Fogg, authentic bagel chips made in Medemsley Road concert.